The blood-brain barrier separates brain tissue from the body's blood circulation. It allows selective passage of iron, glucose, and other small molecules,
shown here as green dots,
from the blood to the brain that are needed for normal brain function, and it shields the brain from dangerous bacteria, viruses, and inflammatory proteins. However, the blood-brain barrier's protective function also blocks potentially helpful drugs from entering the brain. For most drugs taken orally or by injection, less than 1% of each dose crosses the blood-brain barrier to enter the brain. For large molecules such as therapeutic antibodies, the amount crossing into the brain is often even lower than small molecule drugs, 0.1% or less. This limited transport of drugs into the brain reduces the efficacy of many brain-targeted therapies. New, more effective drug delivery methods are urgently needed to help treat diseases of the central nervous system. Scientists working on the Wyss Institute's brain targeting program are helping to address this critical unmet need by developing new targeting strategies to help drugs more effectively reach the brain. To do this, they are exploiting the transcytosis process, in which normally essential molecules such as insulin and iron, shown here in purple, are effectively shuttled across the blood-brain barrier. Specific transcytosis receptor proteins, shown in cyan, bind to their ligands on the blood-exposed surface of endothelial cells, transport them across the endothelial layer, and release them at the brain-exposed surface into the brain. Transcytosis receptors are expressed in blood vessels of all parts of the body. To identify those that are enriched in the blood-brain barrier and could be useful for drug delivery into the brain, these researchers are building a database from the results of deep protein and RNA expression analysis. To search the database for transport target candidates that are expressed at high levels in the brain endothelial cells and lower levels in the endothelial cells of other organs, such as the proteins shown here in cyan, they are developing new bioinformatic algorithms. After discovering new candidate receptors, the team will develop antibodies that bind to them. Then, the specific antibody domain that directly contacts the transcytosis receptors will be isolated and fused to existing antibody drugs targeting brain diseases. These newly engineered antibodies will bind their target transcytosis receptor proteins and be transcytosed to the brain side of the blood-brain barrier. The development of high-quality shuttle antibodies that efficiently cross the human blood-brain barrier could help enable new therapies for a broad range of brain-specific disorders and diseases.